عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. قال الله تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Verily all praise be to Allah. We praise Him and seek His forgiveness. We seek protection in Allah from the evil of our own souls. Whomsoever Allah guides, no one can misguide. And whomsoever Allah allows to go astray, no one can guide. I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Allah. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a slave and messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah mentions in the Quran, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. That fear Allah according to His right and but die not but as Muslims. Die not but as Muslims. Enter Islam completely, not with the commitment, but saying that I am a Muslim. But it's a long-term commitment, a lifelong commitment. That when we say we are Muslims, we will remain Muslims until we die. Will implement the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the footsteps of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our lives the moment we say that we are Muslims. Ikhwan wa akhawat, we find that what we find in ourselves at this very moment, that we claim that we are Muslims, yet we don't understand the reality of the matter. We claim that we are Muslims, but we don't understand the sacrifices that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, or the companions, how they sacrificed their lives for this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And because the understanding, we don't have this kind of understanding, we find ourselves lacking in fulfilling the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our daily life. We find ourselves short in completing the sunnahs of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam while living our daily life. Why? Because we do not understand the importance of what we have. We have taken this deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just mere as a deen. We are listening and we are doing and we are not thinking. We're not contemplating. We're not thinking about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us to do. We're not contemplating about the ayah, fear Allah according to His right and die not but as Muslims. We don't contemplate about the ayahs related to the Jahannam. We don't contemplate about the ayahs related to the Day of Judgment, the Yawm al-Qiyamah. We don't contemplate about the ayahs related to the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah has bestowed on us. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. And if you were to count the blessings of Allah, you will not be able to count. And out of all of the blessings, the greatest of the blessing being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought us to believe in Him and His message. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought us to be Muslims. When someone knows the truth, ikhwan al-kiram al-hawat, when a person knows the truth, they would sacrifice themselves. They would sacrifice their whims and desires for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or for the truth that they believe in. When I know that I'm going to get something out of my job, I will make sure that I'm going to go on time. I'm going to complete the task that have been given to me. Because I know there is an end. There is something that I will get at the end of the month. Why is that not the case with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gives us each and everything. When Allah is the one who has given us the life. When Allah is the one who has given us each and everything that we have. Because we say that we understand the truth, but we don't entirely believe in it. Because if we were to do, we would see the masajid full. If we were to do, we would recite the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day. If we were to do, we would see ourselves look like the Sahaba, act like the Sahaba, be like the Sahaba. But because we are only claiming, we find the problems and difficulties in our lives. Look at the case of Yusuf alayhi salam. When Yusuf alayhi salam was a slave, and he was in the house of the woman, the wife of the Aziz. And what happened? وَرَاوَدَتْهُ الَّتِي هُوَ فِي بَيْتِهِ. Then Yusuf alayhi salam, when he was in the house, the wife of the Aziz, she brought him, she seduced him. And brought him into the house in the room. في بيتها عن نفسه وغلقت الأبواب. She brought him in the house and she closed the doors. She closed the doors because she wanted to seduce him. She wanted him to do something which is haram in Islam. And what did Yusuf alayhi salam say? قال معاذ الله. I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is the reward of someone who did this or who would do that? We know from the hadith of Prophet ﷺ that from the seven of the people, when on the Day of Judgment, there will not be any shade but the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's throne. The person who stops himself in committing such an action will be under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment. That is the reward of what? Of controlling the whims and desires of the person that has. That is the reward of someone to someone who sacrifices what he has in his heart for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I mentioned a story of Julaybib radiyallahu anhu, one of the companions of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Julaybib radiyallahu anhu was of a short stature, was of short height. He was not considered to be from the beautiful Sahaba of Medina. He was from the Ansar. He was a Sahabi that was loved by the Prophet ﷺ. So he was from the Sahaba, but he was not from the well-known of the Sahaba. But he was a Sahabi who was close to the Prophet ﷺ. But because he was of a short height, he was not that beautiful. Sometimes some people would not speak or deal with him in the way they should deal with. And he was a person who was alone. He did not have a wife or he did not have a family. And he wanted to get married. But the people would not give him their daughter or their sisters or anyone they knew. So Julaybib radiallahu anhu went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَوَلَيْسَ مَنْ آمَنَ Are we not from those who believed in you? آمن بك. Then are we not from those who believed in you? And those who believed in you, يدخل الجنة, they will enter the paradise, ويزوج حور العين, and they will marry the حور العين in the Jannah. And the Prophet ﷺ said, yes. Yes, this is the case. I am the Prophet and you believe that anyone who believes in me and does everything that needs to be done, they will enter Jannah. And all of these things will happen. Then Julaybib رضي الله عنه said to the Prophet ﷺ, ما بال أصحابك? What's with your companions? ما بال أصحابك? What's with your companions? For they are not letting their daughters or someone to get married to me. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is that the case? Is that the case? And Julaybib رضي الله عنه said, yes. Then there are a few narrations where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent Julaybib to a certain family in Ansar and said, ask for the hand of their daughter. And there is another one where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked one of the Ansari, the people in Ansar living in Medina, ask for the daughter, for their daughter's hand for Julaybib. So the message sent was sent to this family. And the message was that Prophet ﷺ is asking for the daughter's hand in marriage. And the husband and wife became happy and said, MashaAllah, what great blessing can there be that our daughter getting married to Prophet ﷺ. And the father then said to the mother, no, it is not for the Prophet ﷺ. Prophet ﷺ is asking for the marriage for our daughter, for Julaybib. When the mother heard that, she became upset. She became upset and she said that it could have been Umar radiallahu anhu. It could have been Abu Bakr. It could have been Osman. It could have been anyone. But Julaybib. While this was happening, the daughter was in the room. She came outside. When she came outside, she asked the parents, what is happening? And the parents then told her that this is the case, that the hand of Julaybib had been put forward by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for you. And we don't think it is good. And the daughter replied, do you know what you are doing? The mafhum, the subject, do you know who are you refusing? It is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was asked for me to get married to Julaybib. Go and do what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked us to do, asked you to do, and you will find betterness in it. Then the parents went. They went and they said to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that do what you will to do, you wish to do, and you get them married off. When this information came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Julaybib, oh Julaybib, go and buy something for your wife. Julaybib being a poor person, he said, Ya Allah, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I don't have anything. Then the Sahaba and the companions gave Julaybib radiallahu anhu items to go and buy for the wife. Then the marriage took place. And you know from the narrations, one of the narrations, that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for the wife of Julaybib that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not bring any hardship on her. Some narrations say that after that, there was an expedition that took place. The expedition took place, i.e. the fighting took place, and he heard the call. He heard the call, calling people to come and fight in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Julaybib radiallahu anhu now just got married. And he's thinking, I just got married and I got something that I had wished for. And on the other hand, I have what Allah and His Messenger is asking to do. What should I do? What should I do? He's thinking. He's contemplating. But he knew what was right, what was haq. He knew what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted. He knew what Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had told them to do. So he left his wife and he went in the way with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he died in the battle. When the battle had finished, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to the Sahaba. And he asked them, أَتَفْقِدُ مِنْ أَحَدٍ? Are you missing anyone from yourselves? أَتَفْقِدُ مِنْ أَحَدٍ? And the companions of the Allah said, yes, we are missing.
So and so we are missing. So and so we are missing. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked them again, are you missing anyone else? And the companion said, yes, we are missing so and so. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, but I am missing Jurayb. I am missing Jurayb. The companions and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started to look for Jurayb. And then they found Jurayb. And they found him. And he was dead. He was lying with seven other people. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw him. And he said, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. He killed seven people and they killed him. And he killed seven people and they killed him. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Innahu minni wa ana minhum. He is from me and I am from him. He is from me and I am from him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam picked him up. And he cleaned the dirt from his face. He cleaned the dirt from him and he hugged him. He hugged him. He hugged him and he said, Innahu minni wa ana. He is from me and I am from him. And then he took him. And then he said, now you can marry the woman in Jannah. Ikhwan al-kiram akhawat. The Sahaba knew the haq, what is right. And they sacrificed their life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They did what needed to be done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our brothers and sisters at this very moment can't even come to the masjid to pray, let alone doing anything. They can't even go and do anything or recite the Quran correctly, let alone doing something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is great. We can't even look like the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, let alone doing something which is going to be great. The point being, ikhwan al-kiram, because we don't know the haq in detail, because we have not read it, we have not studied it, we cannot implement it in our life. And we find it difficult when it comes to the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sunnahs of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to implement in our daily lives because the understanding is not. وَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله الحمد لله نستعينه ونستغفره. قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وسلم عليه. آية منشن سورة أحزاب. وما كان لمؤمن ولا مؤمنة إذا قضى الله ورسوله أمرا أن يكون لهم الخيرة أن يكون لهم الخيرة من أمرهم ومن يعص الله ورسوله فقد ضل ضلالا مبينا. It is not fitting for a believer, a man or a woman, when Allah and His Messenger have decreed a matter, that they should have any option in their decision. And whosoever disobeys Allah and His Messenger, he has indeed strayed into error. This ayah was revealed when the wife of Julaybiyah radiallahu anha mentioned this to her family, that go when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had said something to be done. When he has said it, to go and get married to Julaybiyah, to get married to me, we should do it, we should follow it, we should act on it. And it is not the case for a believer. And Allah says, it is not fitting for a believer to go against what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned. وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever your Prophet gives you, take it. Whatever he stops you from, stay away from it. It is not befitting for a believer to go against the commandments of Allah and His Messenger. What does that mean? It means أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ. Follow what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us to follow and follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is also mentioned that once Julaybiyah radiallahu anhu passed away, then the wife of Julaybiyah was one of the most sought after women from among the companions. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ had made dua for her, that Allah does not bring any hardship on her. Brothers and sisters, the lessons are very clear. Very simple. We say we are Muslims, we will find ourselves in difficulty. We will find ourselves in difficulty on some tests and some trials. Allah says in the Quran, do you think we will leave you and we will not test you? We will test you and surely test you again and again. With your life and everything else that we have. For the only way we will get the pleasure of Allah is when we will return back to Him and follow what He has asked us to do while we are living in this life. For there is no going away from it. The Salaf mentioned, the scholars, that one of the lessons that we can take is from the people who have died. The people who have died. That they have died and they don't have anything to do with this world now. And they don't have any opportunity to do with this world now. Because khalas, their time is up. The lessons that we can take from their lives is what can we do now with our lives? How can I change myself now for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Even if it means I have to change the way I talk. Even if it means I have to change the way I dress or behave with my wife, with my children, with my family, with my friends. Even if it means that I am very harsh in speaking with people and I am very firm. Look at what the Prophet ﷺ did in every aspect and step of his life. And then we will find the solution. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring us from the people of Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring us and meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Jalaybi radiallahu anhu in Jannah al-Firdaus. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa astaghfiruhu innahu ghafurur rahim. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wa aqimus salata.